Yes, good afternoon. In last lecture, I explained stoichiometric crystal defect, particularly point defect in which we clearly explained about the Schottky and Frankel defect. In such type of the crystal defect, we observe that the cation number ratio is not changed. It means stoichiometry remains same. But today we shall discuss about those defects due to which stoichiometry of the compound or crystal is changed. Practically, we have observed that sodium chloride is not yellow in color, but we can show sodium chloride to be yellow in color. Lithium chloride is white, but we can prepare pink color lithium chloride. Similarly, sodium chloride is normally white, but we can prepare potassium chloride in violet color. So all these changes takes place only because of the crystal defect, or you can say crystal imperfection. So how these can take place, how we can explain the non-stoichiometric crystal defect? See here, non-stoichiometric defect. So in this type of the crystal defect, stoichiometry of the crystal is changed. It means cation anion ratio number is changed. And these are the types of the non-stoichiometric crystal defect. First, it is the metal excess crystal defect. Metal excess crystal defect is of two type. One, due to anionic vacancy. Second, due to extra metal ion present in the interstitial position of the crystal. Now, second type of the non-stoichiometric crystal defect, it is the metal deficient crystal defect. So these two types of the non-stoichiometric crystal defect can be explained very easily, and we shall take one by one. So let us consider this one, metal excess defect. So this type of the metal crystal defect, when sodium chloride is heated in sodium metal vapor. It looks yellow color. Lithium chloride heated in lithium vapor gives pink color. KCl heated in potassium vapor gives violet color. So all these type of the colors appear due to crystal imperfection, or you can say crystal defect. So how we can explain how metal becomes excess in the crystal? Just consider sodium chloride. This is the sodium chloride crystal. This is the chloride and this is the sodium ion. This is the chloride, this is the sodium ion, chloride, sodium, chloride, sodium, chloride, you can say here, you can take chloride. Here, sodium, chloride, sodium, chloride, sodium, chloride, chloride, sodium, chloride, here sodium, chloride, sodium, chloride, sodium, chloride, sodium, chloride. So this is the Cl negative chloride ion. All are chloride ion. So you can say this is the chloride. This is the chloride ion, Cl ion, and this is the Na plus sodium ion, like this. This is the perfect crystal. Equal number of the cation and anions are present in the crystal. So this crystal is perfect crystal. But what happened when this sodium chloride crystal is heated in the sodium vapor? What will happen? Sodium metal will lose one electron, and sodium atom becomes cation, like this. Here, sodium ion plus one electron sodium metal on heating, it is changed into sodium ion and one electron. Now what happened after this one? This is the crystal, sodium chloride crystal. This crystal is heated in the vapor of the sodium. Sodium ion is formed. So this chloride, it will diffuse like this. Chloride ion will diffuse. And electron of this sodium, it will diffuse inside the crystal. This is the chloride ion already present in the crystal like this of the sodium chloride. Now when this crystal is heated in the vapor of the sodium where sodium ion is formed, one electron is removed. So what happens? This chloride will diffuse outside from inner part of the crystal and it will form sodium chloride like this. And the electron which is present in the vapor of the sodium, it will diffuse inside. So here we shall get electron. So one chloride ion has been removed and it goes out of the crystal, and this crystal point or lattice point is vacant, means a negative hole is created. Now if this electron does not diffuse inside the crystal, what will happen? Certainly number of the cation will be increased, number of the positive charge will be increased, so crystal will be positively charged. But always, one should always remember that crystal should be electrically neutral. So for electrical neutrality, this electron diffuses inside the crystal and this vacant place, it is occupied by the single electron. You can say occupied by unpaired electron. And this unpaired electron, this electron is known as F center. So just imagine, number of the positive charge and number of the negative charge is equal, but number of the chloride ion is decreased inside the crystal. So when number of the chloride ion is decreased in the crystal, automatically number of the sodium ion becomes in excess, and therefore we can say metal excess defect takes place in such type of the crystal. So this is one example. And this electron, when you heat this crystal or you provide some energy, electron transition will take place in different energy state and corresponding color will be given by the crystal. And in case of sodium chloride, this is the sodium chloride and it gives yellow color. When this the sodium chloride is heated in the sodium metal vapor. So one example of the metal excess defect. Similarly, you can represent the same thing in the case of lithium chloride heated with lithium metal, you will get lithium chloride pink color. How pink color? Suppose this is not the sodium ion, like this. This is not the sodium ion, this one. It is the lithium ion, lithium chloride, lithium ion, plus and minus. This is the lithium ion. As soon as this lithium chloride, suppose this is the lithium chloride crystal. So this lithium chloride crystal, when heated in the vapor of the lithium metal, what will happen? Exactly same phenomena take place. Exactly same phenomena. Means lithium water atom will ionize, giving lithium ion and electron. Chloride ion inside the crystal like this, it will diffuse out of the crystal, and electron, this electron will diffuse inside and occupy the vacant place. In this way, again, F center is formed, but the color is different. You can ask, why not if this lithium chloride is yellow? Because crystal energy of the sodium chloride and lithium chloride is different, and therefore the energy transition of the electron from ground to excited state is different, and according you know the color of the light depends upon the energy wavelength, energy related to wavelength. So in this way we can say the change of color. So color change is only on account of the formation of the F center. F center means color center. You can say it color center. Color center. Color center. So color center, and therefore crystal looks like a yellow or pink, or in case of potassium chloride, you will get a violet color. Now there is another type of the non-stoichiometric crystal defect. Non-stoichiometric crystal defect. Second, it is metal deficient crystal non-stoichiometric metric defect. Metal excess non-stoichiometric crystal defect. From the name, we can understand in this type of defect, also stoichiometry of the crystal is changed. Means cation anion number ratio is changed, means stoichiometry of the crystal is changed. Now metal deficient, due to crystal defects, number of the metal ion is decreased, kam ho gaya. मेटल आयन की संख्या निगेटिव आयन की संख्या से कम हो गई, यह डिफिशियंसी माने कमी, मेटल आयन की कमी हो गई. तो हाउ वी कैन एक्सप्लेन हाउ मेटल आयन बिकम्स लेस इन नंबर ड्यू टू क्रिस्टल डिफेक्ट, दैट इज टू एक्सप्लेन हियर. दिस टाइप ऑफ द क्रिस्टल डिफेक्ट आर commonly found in those metal oxides which have variable valency. Transition metal, iron, such as iron. So let us take the example of iron oxide. This is the iron oxide. I take this example. You know iron has two valency. One plus two. Fe plus two. Ferrous. Ferrous ion. Second, फेरिक, फेरिक आयन, नाउ इन केस ऑफ आयरन ऑक्साइड यू विल सी दैट आयरन आयन बिकम्स less in comparison to the number of the oxygen ion. So how we can represent it? Just consider this is the normal FeO crystal. Normal FeO crystal means Fe plus this is the ferrous ion, this is the oxide ion, oxygen, here oxygen, two negative charge, two positive charge, and this is the ferrous oxide. Again, Fe plus two charge, oxygen minus two charge, Fe प्लस दो चार्ज, दिस इज द ऑक्सीजन माइनस दो चार्ज, एफई एंड दिस इज द ऑक्सीजन माइनस चार्ज, एफई एंड दिस इज द ऑक्सीजन माइनस दो चार्ज, एफई कटायन, this is the oxygen and this is the Fe and this is the oxygen and this is the Fe like this. Now what happened when the crystallization take place? Not necessary every ion will occupy the lattice point, and if does not occupy lattice point, crystal defect will automatically occur. If all ferrous ion and oxide ion occupy the lattice point, crystal will be perfect crystal like this. This is the perfect crystal. There is no change in stoichiometry. But anyhow, this oxide ion, it is not occupying the position. So two negative charge has been removed. So you will get extra charge, positive extra charge. Suppose this is the positive ion, this is the positive ion, this is the positive ion. So what will happen? Now just see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 8 ferrous ions. In a perfect crystal, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So in this way, ratio is same. 8 and 7 ratio. But if the oxygen is removed, there is an excess of the cation, ferrous ion. So what will happen? This ferrous ion will change into ferric ion. Ferrous ion will change into ferric ion. And one electron is removed. So in this way, one negative charge of the oxygen has been compensated by this neighboring ferrous ion. This is the neighboring. This neighboring ferrous ion having variable valency, it will lose one electron, ferrous to ferric, and one electron is removed. and this will be electron. Exactly, another electron, negative charge, is balanced by this one. This neighboring ferrous ion, it will also, second ferrous ion, it will also change into ferric ion like this, giving electron. So in this way, two neighboring, either this one or this one, any or this one, you can consider any neighboring, but the ferrous ion must be neighboring. So any one of the neighboring ferrous ion will change into ferric ion, releasing one electron, and in this way electroneutrality remains same, and therefore we can say, just see, this is the metal deficient. This is the metal deficient. This is the oxygen. This has been removed. Ferrous ion has been removed, and this ferrous ion has been removed, and therefore, to compensate the charge, this ferrous will change into ferric, and this ferrous will change into, this ferrous will change into ferric, and it will gain two. It is the vacant. So in this way, 3 plus charge, 3 plus charge. So 2 plus charge of the ferrous. This ferrous has been removed from the lattice point, and 2 plus charge is deficient, and therefore neighboring 2 ferrous ion will change into ferric ion, and therefore charge is compensated, and this is also the F center. Vacancy. So in this way, vacancy is created in this type of the vacancy is created in this type of the crystal defect. Sometimes this is also called as hole, positive hole. So this is all about the crystal defect. It started from the stoichiometric defect and ending to the non-stoichiometric crystal defect. Stoichiometric defect, point defect. One is the vacancy defect, second is the interstitial defect. Vacancy defect, best example, explain Schottky defect. Interstitial defect, best example, Frankel defect. Frankel defect is the self-interstitial defect in which the small cation moves to interstitial position. And also explain the difference between Schottky and Frankel defect. So in such type of the crystal defect, there was no change in stoichiometry. And second defect, non-stoichiometric, in which we explain metal excess defect and metal deficient defect. I would like to explain one example also. Everybody knows about the zinc oxide. Zinc oxide is colorless. Zinc oxide is colorless. But it gives a yellow color on heating. Zinc oxide is white in color. But as soon as we heat zinc oxide, it gives a yellow color. So what is the reason? Why zinc oxide become yellow in color on heating? Very simple. Just you see, zinc oxide, after heating you will get zinc ion. So this is the zinc oxide. Heat it, you will get zinc ion and two electrons. Here, plus half O2, oxygen. This is the O. O means atom. We can write like this, half O2. Oxygen is removed. So if oxygen is removed, this zinc ion, it occupies the interstitial position of the zinc oxide crystal. And therefore, we get a F center inside the zinc oxide crystal, and that F center creates the color. So you can also take the example of zinc oxide as metal excess crystal defect. So I cited one example, sodium chloride. When heated in the sodium vapor, it gives metal excess crystal defect. And you can also take the example of zinc oxide. When it is heated, it gives a yellow color because of the excess, this one, the occupy, zinc ion occupies the interstitial position. And this electron occupies the crystal point, yeah, crystal lattice occupied by the oxygen. This oxygen has been removed. But the space is vacant, and that vacant space will be occupied by electron. So, is prakar se ye electron agar oxygen ke asthan pe chala gaya, to unpaired electron hai, ye kya karega? F center create karega, ab ye excite hoga, to color dega, to iska bhi color yellow aata hai. In this way, we can give two examples, sodium chloride as well as zinc oxide, and lithium chloride or potassium chloride. Thank you very much. Thank you.